A paper published in the Journal of Psychoactive Drugs has given extra support to the power of placebo. It found that giving someone placebo, if it was said to be a prescription stimulant like Adderall, could make people self-report improvements in cognition. This sort of finding exemplifies something that's becoming well understood, namely that a person's expectancies impact not only what a real drug does, but can make a placebo seem like it's doing something. I think results of this sort need to be kept in mind when people are experimenting with alleged cognitive enhancers, whether they're nootropics or LSD microdoses. The background for this paper is that the non-medical use of prescription stimulants has become popular among undergrads and graduate students. They often believe stimulants can improve performance, which contributes to higher use rates. In the US, it's estimated 12 to 20% of university-level students have taken these drugs at some point. Although people may think their performance will improve, the results are often mixed or negative in actual studies. At this point, we still don't have much evidence that amphetamine or methylphenidate significantly improves performance in healthy, non-sleep deprived people. Those with ADHD do consistently receive benefits, yet some papers have found the same drugs in healthy people can't do a whole lot. It's possible some benefits exist, but probably not to the degree people think. A key part of this paper was looking at the impact of positive expectancies on the effects of a placebo. We don't fully know how placebo effects will change based upon preconceived notions. But there's reason to think a placebo can feel like a stimulant, depressant, or another kind of substance, depending on what's expected. 166 participants enrolled in the study, with 86 entering the experimental group and 80 acting as a non-experimental control group. These individuals were undergraduate students with a mean age of 19 years old and an average GPA of 3.45. Experimental participants were asked to pick a dose of alleged Ritalin, Adderall, or Focalin. 74% chose Adderall, which probably indicates a greater familiarity with that drug's alleged positive effects. But keep in mind, everyone ultimately received placebo. They only thought they were getting a prescription stimulant. To measure performance, 4 neuropsychological tests were employed: the D2 test of attention, the PASAT, which measures information processing, a passage comprehension test, and digit span tests to look at short-term memory. They were also given subjective tests of typical positive and negative stimulant symptoms. On the positive side were changes in alertness, focus, and motivation, while the negatives included things like dry mouth, dehydration, and shakiness. The experimental group had no significant positive changes in performance. Rather, those who thought they received a stimulant actually had a potential decline in performance on the PASAT. So, at least in this paper, a placebo stimulant could not actually improve cognitive performance. But that's a bit different from what the users reported. Those who received the placebo stimulant reported significant improvements in alertness, focus, and positive mood, while the control group experienced the opposite, and there was no change between groups in terms of physical symptoms like dry mouth and shakiness. The second part of this paper involved looking for correlations between performance, subjective performance, and expectancies. A large portion of the sample had positive performance-related ideas about stimulants. For example, they felt they could improve focus, improve attention, and sometimes contribute to higher grades. Despite those feelings, higher positive expectancies didn't mediate any true neuropsychological benefit. One of the only correlations was actually between negative expectancies, i.e. about addiction or health issues, and passage comprehension. Experimental participants with higher negative expectancy scores showed improved performance. Whether this is a true finding and what the mechanisms may be are not known. In summary, if you give someone a placebo and tell them it's a stimulant, you can make them think they're under the influence of a cognitive enhancer, and you could even make them feel better overall. Positive expectancies may not actually improve performance, at least according to this paper, but they can mediate self-reported benefits. This sort of research needs to be taken to heart by self-experimenters. Legitimate cognitive enhancers may exist, but I'm inclined to think a lot of the anecdotal reports are heavily tainted by placebo and expectancy. The authors of the paper felt it was surprising that performance didn't improve, despite self-reported subjective improvements in focus, alertness, and pleasant mood in the placebo group. Participants did not perform better across task administrations overall. This substantiates prior research indicating that students' beliefs that stimulant medications are cognitive enhancers are likely misconstrued. The authors concluded by suggesting college administrators begin telling students about these findings in order to reduce expectancies and perhaps the use of stimulants by students. If there's another thing I'm inclined to believe, it's that we probably won't see much of an effect from anti-Adderall public information campaigns. If you have any questions, feel free to put them in the comments. You can also email me with questions. The Drug Classroom is exclusively funded by donations. Listeners like you make TDC possible. If you want to support, please do so on Patreon.